Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 15th video class of DIP, we'll study fundamentals of spatial filtering and smoothing spatial filters in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. So what are spatial filters? Spatial filters are the one which are the filters which are applied on the image plane itself or spatial domain itself. Smoothing spatial filters means the spatial filters which smooth out the image or which blurs the image and remove the noise from the image. So basically these smoothing spatial filters, as we already know, are nothing but low pass filters. So let us start. So spatial filters are one of the techniques of image enhancement in the spatial domain. So we studied in our earlier video classes that image enhancement can be done in the spatial domain or frequency domain. Currently we are learning spatial domain image enhancement techniques, in which we have learned different point processing techniques like image negative, contrast stretching, thresholding, histogram processing, etc. And now we will be studying neighborhood processing, which includes different types of spatial filters. So spatial filtering is a neighborhood processing technique, which is also a spatial domain technique in image enhancement. But unlike the point processing techniques, where we consider one pixel at a time and modify it depending on our requirement, for the neighborhood processing, we not only consider a pixel, but also its immediate neighbors. So for spatial filtering, we change the gray level of a pixel XY depending on the pixel value in a square neighborhood centered at XY using a matrix, which is also known as a spatial filter, spatial mask, spatial kernel or spatial window. So now the question comes in our mind that what is the use of these spatial filters? So there are many things that can be achieved by neighborhood processing which are not possible with point processing techniques, and hence we use image enhancement using neighborhood processing. Now these spatial filters can be broadly classified into two categories, the low pass filters and the high pass filters. We know that the low pass filters are nothing but the smoothing filters or smoothing spatial filters. The high pass filters are known as sharpening spatial filters. The smoothing spatial filters can be further classified into two categories, that is linear filters and non-linear or order statistics spatial filters. In this particular lecture, we'll be learning different linear filters. The linear filters can be averaging filters or weighted averaging filters. So smoothing spatial filters can be averaging linear filters or weighted averaging linear filters. As the name suggests, it is a type of linear filtering in which we'll be doing the averaging of the values of the neighborhood pixel. So to achieve neighborhood processing, a 3x3 mask on the image, we have to multiply each component of the mask with the corresponding value of the image, add them up and place the value that we get at the center of the image. So this operation we already know is same as convolution, and therefore these masks are also known as convolution mask. So what this will do, this will smooth out the image, or this will remove the sharp discontinuities in the image. This smoothing process is used for blurring sharp edges. Say this is our image and this is the spatial mask that we apply on the image. So let us say the coefficients of this mask are W, -1, -1, -1, 0, 1, 1, and so on, and the pixels of the image section under the mask are given by f(x-1, y-1), f(x-1, y), and so on, as we have already learned in our previous video classes. So here the convolution or the sum of the products is given by r is equal to, take the first value of the mask, multiply this with the first value over here, that is w -1, -1 into f(x-1, y-1) plus of, take the second value, multiply this second value with the second value of the filter, and so on. We take the sum of product of the whole image, and this operation can be given by the equation g(xy) is equal to summation of s is equal to -a to a, t is equal to -b to b, w(s, t) f(x+s, y+t). So we know this equation is the same that is used for convolution, where a is equal to m-1/2 and b is equal to n-1/2 for a m×n mask. So this mask is a m×n mask, where m is equal to 2a+1 and n is equal to 2b+1. So the smallest value of a and b is 1. So replacing 1, we will get a 3x3 mask. If we take a and b is equal to 2, we will get 5x5 mask, and so on. Hence the size of the mask must be odd to ensure that it has a center, and of course the smallest meaningful size is 3x3, as we have chosen here. So the mechanism of spatial filtering, which is shown here, consists simply of moving the filter mask from pixel to pixel in an image. At each pixel XY, the response of the filter at that pixel is calculated using predefined relationship, that is linear or non-linear. If it is linear relationship, it is a linear filter, such as averaging filter or weighted averaging filter. If it is non-linear, then it is a order statistics filter, such as median filter. So the basic idea behind smoothing filters is very straightforward. By replacing the value of every pixel in an image by the average value of the intensity levels in the neighborhood defined by the filter mask, this process results in image with reduced sharp transitions in intensities. And because random noise typically consists of sharp transitions in intensity levels, the most obvious application of the smoothing filter is noise reduction. So before understanding how to apply the averaging filter, it is important to understand what we mean by frequencies in an image. We say that this is a low pass filter. As for the electrical signals, we see that how many more number of oscillations are present, the higher is the frequency. The same concept can be applied to the images. In images, instead of voltages, we have gray levels. So if the gray level changes slowly over a region, it is considered to have a low frequency, whereas if the gray level changes very rapidly, the region is considered to have high frequencies. So hence in images, regions where the gray level change slowly are low frequency regions, and regions which have abrupt gray level changes are high frequency areas. So for most of the images, the background is considered to be low frequency region, whereas the edges are considered to be high frequency regions. Hence, low pass filtering implies removing or blurring the edges, while high pass filtering implies removing the background. Let us understand one example of smoothing spatial filter or averaging spatial filter. This is known as averaging spatial filter since we are normalizing the values that we obtain for the image by dividing all the values by the total of the coefficients of filter mask. So such filter masks are also known as box filters. So box filter is one in which all the coefficients are equal. So spatial averaging filter in which all the coefficients are equal is sometimes called a box filter. So see this input image. This input image is consisting of most of the white values which are near to 255, as we can see here. But there are two values which are near to black or black, and these two values act as a noise in this particular image. So to remove this noise, we use a box filter like this. So we have to perform the convolution process on this input image. Let us say we apply this filter mask to this particular section. So we'll place this filter mask on these pixels of the input image and calculate the sum of the products using convolution. So for obtaining the value at this particular point, that is 5, we'll multiply 1 with 200. So it will be 1 into 200 plus 1 into 215 plus 1 into 212 plus 1 into 198 plus of 1 into 5 plus 1 into 202 plus 1 into 199 plus of 1 into 207 plus of 1 into 202, and this whole will be divided by 9, as it is 1/9. This will give us 1640 divided by 9, which comes out to be 182.22. So we'll round off this to 182. So in the output image, this 5 will now get converted into 182. So this is how we perform filtering. Similarly, for this particular point, the value which we'll be getting will be 183, and these are the other values which we will be obtaining. Now you may have a question in your mind that what are the values that should be chosen when the mask is at the border. So when the mask is like this, that is at the border, we can pad the blank values with the neighboring values, or we can replicate the neighboring values. That means here it will be replicated as 200, 215 and 212, and so on. You can replicate the values for all the blank values when the mask is at the border of the image. So this will be the output image that you'll be obtaining. And now we can note that these two noise points, that is 5 and 0, which are dark or black points, these two noises are replaced with the average of their surrounding points. You can see here, this has become 182 and this has become 183. So this process of reducing the influence of noise is called smoothing or blurring. So this is known as low pass filtering. So sometimes, rather than using the box filter having equal coefficient, we use a weighted average filter, like multiplied by 1/16, as the total coefficient values of all these values is 16. So this mask yields a so-called weighted average terminology, used to indicate that pixels are multiplied by different coefficients, thus giving more importance or weight to some pixel at the expense of the others. So the basic strategy behind weighting the center point the highest and then reducing the value of the coefficients as a function of increasing distance from the origin is simply an attempt to reduce blurring in the smoothing process. So to remove the blur, we use a weighted average filter. So this figure shows the effect of averaging filter. Figure A is our original image, and B to F, this is B, C, D, E and F, are the results of smoothing with square averaging filter mask of size 3x3, 5x5, 9x9, 15x15 and 35x35. So you can see as the mask size increases, the blurring of the image increases. But of course, the noise also gets removed. You can see here, these are the noises. Okay, and these noise are completely removed as you increase the filter size. For example, see a image in which random Gaussian noise is added, and after low pass filtering, the noise gets removed. So let us perform this low pass filter in MATLAB. So this is the MATLAB program. We are reading an image which is a color image and converting that color image into grayscale image using RGB to gray command, and we are adding random Gaussian noise to the image using randn function. So randn function will create a random Gaussian noise that is added to the original image A. So now the image A consists of the original image as well as the random noise that is added to it. Now we need to remove this noise, and for removing that noise we are taking a box filter of 3x3, and then I am applying this filter mask to my image A using I is equal to IM filter AW. So IM filter AW filters the image A with filter W, and then I am displaying my image with the noise and the filtered image side by side using the montage command. So let us run this program and see the output. So you can see here, this is our image with random Gaussian noise added to it, and after low pass filtering you can see that we are able to remove majority of the noise from the image, and the image has become a smooth image. Let us change the box filter from 3x3 filter to a 5x5. So I will disable this line and I will enable this line. So we can even create the filter using fspatial command. Fspatial function can create the filter, and this one will create a 5x5 box filter. So now you can see that majority of the noise has got removed, but of course the image has become blurred also, as you can see in this display board. So as we have just learned, for removing this blurring we can use a weighted average filter in place of the box filter. So I will disable this line and enable this line. So now you can see that the blurring has been reduced to some extent using the weighted average filter. Now let us disable this weighted average filter line and enable this spatial filter again, and rather than adding the noise using randn function, we can even add the noise using IM noise A Gaussian. So IM noise A Gaussian 0.01 adds Gaussian white noise with mean 0.01 and variance of 0.01. So you can see here that here also the noise has been added and has been removed using smoothing. Now rather than adding the Gaussian noise, let us add the salt and pepper noise using IM noise A salt and pepper 0.02. So IM noise A salt and pepper 0.02 adds salt and pepper noise with noise density of 2% to the image, and we are of course filtering using our special filter of 5x5. So you can see here that the image is added with salt and pepper noise. So as the name suggests, it is a salt and pepper noise. That means the noise that is in white and black dots. Salt means white dots and pepper means black dots, as you can see in the image. And this noise is removed by using the smoothing filter. But of course, the image has become much blurred and not all the noise has been successfully removed from the image. So we can conclude that low pass filter is not efficient for removing the salt and pepper noise. So what is the solution for that? The solution for that is the order statistic filter, median filter, that we'll be learning in the next video class. So that is all for this video lecture. In the next video lecture we'll be learning order statistics or nonlinear spatial filters. Thank you very much.